Good morning, everyone, and welcome back to the Carnahan fam. We hope you had a Merry Christmas, a Happy New Year, and are ready to jump into some new preschool curriculum for this coming winter. Our next preschool theme that will be released on Friday is our winter theme, which is about all things winter. So snow, snowmen, things that keep you warm, including the clothes and the drinks, activities to do in the snow, all of those fun things. So today we wanted to share 5 of our favorite winter books that are gonna be featured in this unit, and also some activities that you can do with these books to kind of bring these books to life and help your child to get excited about reading these stories and then even diving into them a little bit deeper. All of the books that we'll be sharing today are in the description below in our Amazon storefront, amazon.com/shop/thecarnahanfam. There's a section called Winter Theme Preschool where you can find links to all of these books and other resources that we recommend for your winter preschool themed unit. I actually had a really hard time narrowing it down to 5. So I have 5 that I'm gonna share with you that also have activities to go along with it, and then just a bonus 2 at the end that are just books I couldn't leave out. The first book I wanted to share with you was Sneezy the Snowman by Maureen Wright. And I love this book because it is about Sneezy the Snowman, who sneezes all the time because he's always so cold. So he finds ways to warm himself up throughout the book. But of course, what happens when a snowman gets warm? He melts. And so he's finding ways throughout the book to try to stay warm without melting. This book also has a lot of repetitive phrases, which is really good for developing that phonemic awareness for your young preschooler. To go along with this activity, we did a melted snowman, and there's tons of different ways that you can do a melted snowman. But with this, I've always wanted to try puffy paint. So we did a puffy paint craft, making a blob of snowman, and then added all of the pieces on top that really give that snowman his character, his eyes, nose, arms, all the things. So that's book number 1. Book number 2 is There Was a Cold Lady Who Swallowed Some Snow. And it is a spin-off of There Was an Old Lady Who Swallowed a Fly. But this old lady who swallows some snow, swallows a pipe, some coal, a hat, a stick, a scarf. Books like this where your child is already familiar with the structure and just has a little bit of change of words is a great way to help, again, to build phonemic awareness, but also to be able to help them sequence because the story is more predictable. If you're familiar with There Was an Old Lady Who Swallowed a Fly, these books do have a repetitive nature, repeating the same thing over and over, which again helps build phonemic awareness. So to go along with this book, you can do a retelling activity, cutting out the little old lady from the printable in the description below, and then feed the little old lady all of the things that she eats in the book, either while you're reading the book or right after in the end. You can do a little retell and feed the little old lady all the things that she eats throughout the book. Then at the end, she hiccups twice and out pops a snowman. So we've also included a cute little snowman cutout that you can already have in your little old lady that you can pull out at the end to pop out your little old snowman. Number 3 on our list today is a really simple book called One Mitten. And this book is by Christine O'Connell George. And I love this story because it is all about a child's imagination and what they can think up with one mitten. So the mitten can be a shadow puppet, it can be a hat or a sleeping bag, it can be a flag, and so many more things. Later in the book, the little girl gets 2 mittens and thinks up all of these fun things that you can do with 2 mittens. And for this book, you can go ahead and grab your own 1 or 2 mittens and act out these things as you go along reading the story with your preschooler. And while you're at it, see how many other things that you two can come up with together that you can do with a mitten. I think you'll be surprised with how creative your little one can be. This is a great, great story to encourage your child to be creative, to use their imagination and think outside the box. The next story is another very simple favorite, Footprints in the Snow by Cynthia Benjamin. In this story, it begins to snow and we have different animals who are heading home. And that's what it repeats throughout the story. Someone hops, home. Someone runs, home, and so on. Again, the repetitive nature of the story is so good for your preschooler to be able to really hone in on those comprehension skills, tune in their listening ears, repeat the word home throughout the story, and even to just to dive in deeper to seeing how different animals might travel back home. There are so many great verbs in this story between stomps, swims, walks, hops, that you can act out while telling the story with your child. Talking about the similarities and differences between the animals and the ways that they're traveling. But one thing that we loved doing with this story was making ourselves a batch of white Play-Doh. And if you don't have a Play-Doh recipe yet, go ahead and watch this video next or follow the link in the description below to our super soft forever Play-Doh recipe that I can't recommend enough. And just make yourself a little batch of white Play-Doh, lay it out, and with little animal figurines, travel home through the snow. What's so fun about this is that you can see the little animal tracks in the Play-Doh as you are playing and retelling with your preschooler. Now, of course, we didn't have all the same animals that match in this, so we got to explore with dinosaurs traveling through the snow and giraffes and elephants stomping through the snow. So whatever you have on hand will work just fine. Our last activity paired story that we're gonna share today is Snowmen at Night. This is a super silly story about a little boy who makes a snowman one day and then wakes up the next day and he's a little slumpy. So he starts to wonder, what did his snowman do all night long? Are the snowmen making hot chocolate and hanging out? Are they laughing like clowns and rolling in the snow? There are so many fun things that this kiddo in the story thinks up as he thinks about what the snowman could be doing at night. And again, it's a great opportunity for your child to be able to think of something creative of what they think that the snowman might do at night. And with this book, we paired another snowman craft, making your own snowman at night. And if you have an older preschooler and want to have them dictate or tell you what they think the snowman's doing at night, you might write that on the bottom of their picture so you can dictate the illustration and the artwork that they've provided for Snowmen at Night. Now, just two books I couldn't leave out that aren't actually paired with an activity this time are Five Little Penguins Slipping on the Ice by Steve Metzger. And I love this story because it's essentially five little monkeys jumping on the bed. So it has the same story structure. Five little penguins slipping on the ice. One fell down. Ouch, that's not nice. Mother called the doctor and the doctor said, no more penguins slipping on the ice. And it goes through all the penguins slipping on the ice, as does five little monkeys jumping on the bed. I just love the story structure of this one. It's so familiar to kiddos if they are familiar with Five Little Monkeys Jumping on the Bed. And it's a great book for them to be able to mimic and rehearse, no more penguins slipping on the ice. And this is Snow Day by Betsy Maestro. And I actually love this book because of how much it talks about the process that a city might go through with cleaning up the snow. So if you live in a heavy snow area and your child might be wondering about the snow plows that they see on the road, this is a super great book. So we have in the beginning of the book, obviously it starts to snow. The kids have a snow day because there's so much snow on the ground, and it starts off saying, even before the snow stopped falling, town worker crews were out on their trucks to begin the long, hard job of digging out. So it talks about the workers that go out and clear the snow from the roadways. This book also talks about other people who help. On the next page, it says, up and down the streets, people come out to shovel and sand the sidewalks and driveways. Neighbors help each other using big snow blowers to get the job done. And I love the way it talks about crews and people and neighbors coming together to help clear the snow. It is a great informational story on clearing the snow and about community helpers. And that's another reason why I just love that story. There are so many more stories that we could add to this list, but this is a really good start for some books to add to your winter collection as you and your preschooler begin a deeper study on winter over the next few weeks. Be sure to be back on Friday when we release our winter curriculum and give away our 10 free copies of our whole unit theme. We've got so many more fun activities, art projects, and learning opportunities to do with your child, so you're definitely not gonna wanna miss it. Have a wonderful day, you guys, and we'll see you next time. Bye.